If you've been watching my videos for a while, you know I love to use a plugin called Optics from Boris FX. Just this week, they've updated it to version 2025. So I want to show you the brand new features. And this video has been sponsored by Boris FX. Let's jump in and have a look and see what's new. I know a lot of my subscribers are familiar with Boris FX Optics. This is the new 2025 version, and it's got a lot of significant updates, just came out this week. Let me show you the main new features. So let's start with this photo I shot of Megan. What we're going to do is go into Optics. So we're going to choose Filter, Boris FX, and then we're going to choose Optics. Now, the first thing it's going to do is it's going to load your image in, and it's going to offer to apply your previous adjustments. We're going to say no, we're going to start from scratch. All right, so let's have a look at some of the different things that we can do in here. If you look across the bottom, you'll see there's lots of different categories of different things that we can do. Now, there's many, many options in here. So we go through the different categories, and you'll see there's lots and lots of different types of filters and adjustments. Now, the thing that makes these really powerful is each one of these not only have presets, but they have infinite adjustments. Let me show you. We'll go into, say, the color. And let's look at some of the color options. As I scroll across the bottom, you can see all the different ones. Let's go into the film lab. And then we're going to grab this option here. Boris FX also make video products, which most of the movie industry uses. So you've seen these effects on television and on movies. And these are inside of Optics and available for our still images. So you can see these are really, really high quality presets that you can grab in just a single click, and you can go in here and you can adjust things. But it goes much further than that. Let's say, for example, we want to create some kind of a particle effect. So let's go in, we're going to create a new layer. And then under this layer, we're going to choose light. And we've got different types of light effects that we can apply. Let's kind of click on here, and notice once you do that, you get all these different presets, and all of these presets have all types of different adjustments that we can apply very, very quickly. Ooh, that stars in space is kind of cool. I kind of like this one, but what if I want to put it behind our model and not in front? Well, the first thing we can do is we can go in here, we can just adjust this a little bit. Let's make some adjustments. And notice as I roll down, I can change all kinds of things like the color. I think we can go for this kind of a color and apply it. All right, so what we want to do now is we want to have it just behind Megan. So one of the new features is the new masking options. So if we go here, we'll notice the layers, select that top layer, and then we're going to add a mask. So click the plus button, and this gives you the different types of masks that you can create. The newest one that's just been added is Mask ML, which uses machine learning for an AI mask. And let's just click on that. And now it's going to load the AI model, and it's ready to create the mask. Really easy to use. What we do is we hold down the Alt or the Option key, and as we roll over, you can see the different areas that are going to be selected. It uses machine learning to select those. So let's just click to apply it. Notice you'll get that little green dot there that shows that area is applied. Let's just keep holding down that Alt or Option key, click on some different areas, and see where we can go as far as selecting everything. All right, that's pretty close. That looks like we've missed a little bit there. Let's just click there. Great. So right now, the mask is a little rough, but we haven't generated it yet. Let's go up here, and we're going to generate it by clicking that Generate button. And there we go. Notice that will smoothen it off. Now, what I want to do is I want to put it behind Megan instead of on top of her. So select the mask, and then just choose Invert. And now we get this really cool effect right behind her. But let's continue looking at the new features. So one of the things that's nice is the customizable workspace. So I can drag any of these tabs around within the panels and reposition them. Or if I want, I can grab the panels themselves, and I can drag them into different positions as well. So you can completely rearrange it. We also have custom workspaces. So if we go under Workspace, and let's choose the Advanced space, look at this. It looks a lot more like Photoshop. Here's our layers on the right with all our parameters, and then all our presets on the left. So we can work that way. Let's put it back to the default. And we're just going to reset everything. Just choose the Reset All. Puts it back to the factory settings. All right, let's use this image I shot of Crystal, and I want to show you an amazing new feature under Particle Illusion. So if we go to Particle Illusion, we now have the ability to work with these amazing brushes. So if I choose one of these particles, I can drag this around. Watch this. So say I want to go, let's start from the back here, and I want to draw up and around. Notice what I'm doing. I'm adding this really cool effect up and around. Oh, got a little carried away with that. That's fine. All right. So notice I've created this path. Now we can adjust this. We can do a lot of different things with it. First of all, I can choose different effects if I want, just by simply clicking. And notice we can get all kinds of, you know, really interesting effects there. By the way, I warn you, you can spend a lot of time playing around in here because there's a lot of fun stuff. But notice it's a little bit jaggy. Okay, so here's the thing. So if we go to the parameters over here, and let me just drag this down so we can see it a little better. And we can see there's Particle Illusion. Now you could go and launch the whole Particle Illusion app, but we can do what we need right here. Let's give it a bit more time. Notice as I'm increasing the amount of time, and I can just click here and just type in, let's say 100. There we go. And that's going to smoothen it off because it gives it more time to play with. But the other thing is if we move it through different parts of time, let's have a look here. So we're looking at the duration here. But notice as I change this, see how we can just go back to different points in time here. And we can do this with the slider if we want. So see how we can kind of move it and get it exactly where we want it to go. And we can change the properties of these. Now, if we give them life, that means it's going to last longer and this will extend this. Watch this. See how that extends that path now, gives it a little bit more life. So why don't we do that? And then what we'll do is we'll drag this one further on. So we're going to take that duration all the way so we get the whole path that we've created there. Now the number is going to give us, you know, more or less of these little particles so we can control how dense they are. We can change the size of them. We can make them larger. We can make them smaller. We can do all the fun stuff that we want. All right, let me show you another thing that we can do. So say we want to build something up a little bit. Go to some different film effects. So you might see some of these presets, like different TV shows or movies that kind of emulate that kind of a look there. So we can kind of try some of this. Let's put a little bit of that film damage on there. All right, let's create another layer. Let's put some light effects on here. Let's do a glow. Maybe it's a little strong. Let's bring it down a little bit. All right, so we've kind of created this look. Now, here's the thing. We can save these. We've always been able to save presets, but now we can save out what are known as looks. So the nice thing is if we look at the layers in here, this is what we just built up. But if I choose to choose something else like here, notice it changes it. Same with here. What it does is it actually loads in all the different layers with all the different adjustments and masks. And all of those can be saved if each one of those looks and brought back in a single click. The nice thing about this, these can easily be shared. Now, if you go up under the file menu, if you click create look, as I just did, you can create your own look, but you can also export them and you can share them with other people, or you can import your own. If we choose import, you'll see there's one there. It's an optics.optics file. I've already imported it, so I don't need to bring it in again. But as you can see, you can easily share those with other Optics users. And those are your main new features inside of Optics 2025. As you can see, it's a pretty big upgrade. I encourage you guys to check it out. I'll put a link underneath. So as you can see, some exciting new features in there. One of my favorites is definitely the Mask ML, as well as being able to do a particle illusion with that pen. That's going to be really useful. So drop your comments underneath. Let me know what you think about this. Are you a BorisFX user? Have you been using it for a while? I'm really curious. I'll give you a link where you can go and buy it. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Consider hitting that subscribe button. Turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.